In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to get Microsoft Office for free. That's right, you don't need no credit cards, no debit cards, no parents' wallets, or cash to get this for free. And I'm going to show you guys how to do this in just a few minutes. Without further ado, let's get started. Before we start, I just want to give a big shout out to Kevin Stratford for coming up with this video idea to begin with. He did a video on this right here, so if you haven't seen it already, make sure to check that out. But without further ado, let's get to the tutorial. So as you can see here on my screen right here, all you have to do in order to start the process of getting Microsoft Office for free is you need to type in right up here, just www.office.com. Now that's going to bring you to this site right here that you see. Now once you're on this site, not to worry, it might be, you know, maybe it's a little confusing. You know, you're scrolling around, you're like, what the heck's going on? How do I get it for free? I want it for free. Well, here's what you can do. And by the way, this is all legal, so don't worry about it. So you have three options right here. You have sign in, get Office, which is the paid version.
We don't want that today. Mm-mm.
Or sign up for the free version of Office. Now, if you don't already have an Office account, which is tied to any email that you may have tied to Microsoft Office, you're going to want to pick this option right here. But if you do, like myself, I've already created an office.com account, then you can just sign in right here. And by the way, when you are signing up, if you don't have an account already, you can use any type of email. I actually used a Gmail account to sign up, so you don't need to worry about having any specific email to actually create an account. Super easy. Window pops up, sign in, and you're good to go for step two. All right, so now that I already have an account, I'm going to click here and say sign in. Then this screen's going to pop up. It's actually my old YouTube channel name, which was PowerPoint Made Simple. If any of you guys that are watching this right now remember that channel name, let me know in the comments down below. You guys are the true OGs and appreciate that you guys are still here to this day. All right, so I'm going to click here right now. Then it's going to ask you for a password. Please, no one hack me. I do not want to get hacked. Please, please, please. Now what we need to do, and I'm going to move myself to the right here, is you're going to see all these different applications right here. And then you can upload, open, new, whatever you want, you can go nuts. To start, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna look here, and since I do a bunch of PowerPoint videos, let's start with PowerPoint. Let's see if we can get PowerPoint up and running in just a few seconds. Click here. Then you're gonna have this option to create a new PowerPoint presentation, and recent pin share with me. This will show up if you have other documents already created. So you can click new blank presentation. You need to verify your identity. It's just gonna ask for your password. Super secure. We love that, Microsoft. All right, so now that we are signed in, we now have created our first presentation. So now it's going to show you all these different features right here. Designer for free. Now, this is pretty cool. All right, let's try it out. So look at this. I'm going to click this in here. And now when I go in presentation mode, look at this. Oh my goodness, you guys. This is unreal. Look at that. You have your presentation already with fireworks on it. This is ridiculous. Okay, this is crazy.
What the heck?
I didn't even remember that this was a feature. So these are free suggestions that Microsoft Office so kindly suggested that you guys can include in your presentations. And this is pretty awesome. They're suggesting already to add video as a background, which is something I've been always suggesting for PowerPoint presentations, because who doesn't want a little video in motion? But don't put in too many of your slides, because then you're going to start getting a little distracting. So anyways, this is how you can create a presentation. You can also save it right here, save as, you can share it. And now you're probably wondering, okay, well now where's it going to go? Like, let's say I go back here. Whoops, got to save it. Well, not to worry. It's saved to
the cloud,
which is amazing. So you're probably wondering, okay, maybe this file took up a little bit of space. This is free. Where's this getting stored? Stored to the cloud. How much space do I have? Well, Microsoft Office so kindly gave you 5 gigabytes of free storage. So how can you see where that storage is located? Click on this grid right here and then go to OneDrive. You're gonna see that I have a total of 5 gigabytes of storage. Not bad. I like that. So it's a pretty nice feature that Microsoft Office has decided to give you. Obviously, if you go premium, you get 1 terabyte, which that's amazing. So that might be an option. And obviously, there's going to be a lot of suggested selling to go with the Microsoft Office 365. But I mean, it is their product, so I would assume they would want to do that. For the most part, you can use Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote. I've never heard of Family Safety, but you can use that too. OneDrive, and you can use it personal vault, which is awesome. pictures, documents, and then all my presentations are right here. I also did a test run before this, so if you ever wanted to delete it, you could. This is just a simple way to use Microsoft for free. So let's say we go back to PowerPoint and we go back into our presentation and open it up, and you're probably wondering, okay, Tyler, I watched a bunch of PowerPoint videos. If you haven't, check them out right here. But if you have watched a bunch of those videos, you're gonna wonder, can I do all the things I can in regular PowerPoint? And the answer to that is yes and no. So there's a lot of features in here that you can do, but it's gonna be limited. And just know that when you're using the free version, it's just kind of how it is for most software applications in the free version, but you can still do a lot of things in this. Save it, use it for free. Maybe you have a class presentation. This is all a great way to figure out how to use Microsoft Office for free. Now, another thing is let's say you're going to school and maybe your school offers a free license to Microsoft Office. There's a way to actually redeem that. So I would make sure to look into all the different options before even testing out the free version, because maybe you can get the full Microsoft Office 365 version for free from your school if you're still a student. Now, if you aren't, if you're out of school, kind of like myself, where, you know, maybe you can't afford Microsoft Office 365. Now, fortunately, my work provides it for me for free, but if you can't afford it and you always want the most up-to-date version with limited features, but it still works well, this is a great way to get it. All right, so that is how you can get Microsoft Office for free today. If you did like this video, make sure you give a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more things about PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.